The world is very different now. The world is very different now.
It's that time of year again. The government decides to kick back a small portion of some of the money it's stolen from us over the last year. Everyone knows it's time for income tax returns to come in, and it seems just about everyone is scheming on a way to get a hold of yours. Apartment complexes willing to take an IOU for your refund, furniture stores and car lots offering to cash your check as collateral against the loan. If you didn't know better, you'd think that these people all thought we're just easy suckers who can't wait to splurge our money at the first opportunity. They act like we don't care about our bills or our lower standard of living, and instead we'll blow any financial windfall we get on flashy trinkets and cheap ornaments. Of course, the problem is, they know they're right. It's a time-honored tradition, especially among black people, that money is made to be spent. Boy, do we spend it. In a capitalistic society, we're all consumers, but black people have gone well beyond that. We engage in the all-American cult of consumerism. Being a consumer is buying what you need. Consumerism is buying because you can. And for what? A friend of mine once told me, black people are the only people in the world who will show everyone exactly how much money we have. And she was right. There's no way they can miss it. We wear our weekly paycheck on our head. We put our bonuses on our feet. We put our income tax returns on our car tires. And we stick our life savings. Well, after all that ridiculous spending, we don't have any savings. We spend our money on expensive trivialities. It's as if we're trying to cope with something we think we're lacking by overcompensating. This is what my friend calls material therapy. Like a bunch of scorned high schoolers trying to get even with the snooty kids at school by getting a bigger limousine than they have. And so we spend. We spend all of our paychecks. We spend all that we have. And when that's gone, we get some credit cards so we can spend that too. And when our credit's blown, we start taking money from any families or friends who'll be stupid enough to lend it to us. Because we want all kinds of things we really can't afford in order to impress people. And who are we trying to impress? Why, we're trying to impress people we know, and more importantly, people we don't. We're living a fantasy that somehow we're on par with basketball players and other millionaires, never mind the fact we're mired in debt and can't pay the rent. The problem with black people trying to use money to impress people is that is not the purpose of money. You are supposed to spend money to buy things you will actually use and to make more money. Instead, we try to use the money for the few fleeting seconds of admiration we'll gain from a perfect stranger on a street corner who just might happen to see the rims on our car, or to impress the checkout girl at your local dollar store who might happen to be momentarily impressed with the jacket you're wearing. All this effort to get the attention of people in the same miserable financial boat you are is so pointless because the people who care don't count, and the people who count don't care. Do you think Warren Buffett or Donald Trump are in awe of your rims? Do you think Bill Gates is in amazement over you spending your income tax return on your chameleon paint job? Do you think Sumner Redstone and Chris Knight are enraptured by your new hairdo? Of course not. They're all just wondering how soon it'll be before they get their piece of your voracious spending habits. White men don't spend money for fun. White men spend money to make money, and black people should be the same way. If it don't make dollars, it don't make sense. You need to spend your little tax return on something that's gonna last. Use it as a foundation to invest in some real estate. Start working on that small business idea you've been talking about for years and haven't lifted a finger to make happen because I don't have the money. Meanwhile, you dump every dollar you get into the local non-black merchant store. I'm not going to accept any excuses. If the Vietnamese boat people can start a candy store and they don't even speak the language, then you can too. If you like clothes so much, why don't you start a clothing store instead of leaving your entire paycheck at one? It was once said, black people tend to work for what they want and beg for what they need, and for too many of us, that is still true. When we get a dollar, we are completely unhappy until it's spent in the most frivolous manner possible. Why don't we make this year different? Why don't we keep our money in our pocket and see if we can start getting some other people's money for a change? Everybody wants some paper, paper. Niggas fighting over paper. Everybody wants some paper, paper. Niggas fighting over paper.